Okay, so let me introduce our second speaker. The next speaker is Dr. Junyan Zhang from National Taiwan Normal University in Taiwan. Did I pronounce your name correctly? He is a chair professor and the director of Science Education Center at National Taiwan Normal University. Over the past few years, he has been a visiting professor at the Taipei Medical University, the Education University of Hong Kong, and the Paris 8 University. His major research interests include science education, e-learning, interdisciplinary science learning, and science communication. The title of his presentation today is Developing Pre-Service Teachers TPAC through the D-Code model. So please give him a big hand.
Thank you so much for great introduction, and thank you so much for inviting me again here after pandemics. Okay, so I would like to introduce some of the research my group has been doing for the past since 2019, right before the pandemics. So we are actually trying to improve teachers' TPAC, not only for pre-service but also for in-service teachers through a new model, which I, you know, sort of invented before the pandemic, okay? So before I do that, of course, I want to, you know, if everybody talk about TPAC, you know, technological, pedagogical content knowledge, so we always, you know, need to refer this most classic work by Lee Shuman in 1986. And over there, he coined the term pedagogical content knowledge. Then later on, you know, you put technology, whatever you put it, but you know, this is the most important work. So he, in this article, he actually write a thing, you know, quote Bernard Shaw saying like, you know, he who can does, he who cannot teaches. So which is kind of an assault, okay? You know, on teaching profession, okay? So, you know, then everybody think, okay, teacher, you know, like, you know, if you cannot do anything, you just become a teacher. So I think I also, like, you know, read this, you know, maybe 10, 15 years ago in at the last conference. So they extended to those who can do, those who can teach, those who can teach, teach teachers. So that's how we do at the National Taiwan Normal University, okay? Then those who can teach teachers do research. Those who can do research, teach research. So teaching is always seems like, you know, at the top of everything, like, you know, if you cannot do anything, you know, you just, you know, teach. Then so then we continue. Those who can teach research, write research papers. Those who can write research papers, teach how to write research papers. Then this can go on and go on. Okay, so this is, although it's a joke, but it's kind of like, you know, teaching as a profession, is really a profession, or you know, it's just, you know, like, you know, everybody can do it. So what my talk today, I will, because I only have 30 minutes, usually it's kind of like a 1 hour talk. So I will only introduce you, you know, very quickly regarding teacher knowledge, then TPAC. Then I will skip ICT policy in Taiwan, and MacDill model I will skip because that was a model we developed 10 years ago. Before the DECODE model. So now I will jump to DECODE model. Then I will present you several studies we have been doing for the past 3-4 years. Then I will give you some of my final thoughts, okay? So in terms of teacher knowledge, I think, you know, I mean, especially like TPAC. So in addition to Lee Shuman, we also have like, you know, Mishra and Denise. They, you know, raised, you know, the very important issue, not only pedagogical, but also technological, because for the past, I would say, you know, 20 years, we have computer age, and then we have internet age, okay? But I always want, whenever I talk about TPAC, I always want to go back to the original, you know, statement by Lee Shuman, because that's the most important thing. If you look at, you know, even 40 years later, it still, you know, apply. So the most useful forms of representation of those ideas, the most powerful energy, illustration, example, explanation, demonstration, in a word, the ways of representing and formulating the structure that make it comprehensible to others. So, and go on. So, you know, if you can also add technology, anything, you know, if you want to add, you know, to PCK, that's still valid today, in my opinion, Okay, so if you, you know, look at leadership movement's work, we will know, like, you know, as a teacher, how you really, you know, acquire those, not only content knowledge, but the pedagogical content, pedagogical knowledge, technological knowledge, and then you actually integrate those knowledge into your teaching, then you really implement it very well. I think that's the best, most, you know, challenging things for as a teacher. So of course, Michelle later on, I did, you know, like, you know, in the in before a TPAC, you know, the content drives the most decision for pedagogy and also technology. But the, when internet comes, you know, TikTok, AI, you know, all the technology new can come. Actually, the technology itself drive how you really, what kind of content you can teach, what kind of pedagogy you can use in the classroom. So, you know, it seems like, you know, technology itself actually also, you know, drive, you know, all the different things. So, you know, I always, you know, like joke about, like, you know, right now as a teacher, you need to have all this, you know, different kind of knowledge. You see there are three circles, they are overlaying a place now, TPAC in the middle. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. As a teacher, you need to have all this knowledge. You know, this is a, do you think it's possible? Hey guys, you think it's possible? Like, you know, as a teacher with such low salary, like in professor in Taiwan, very, very low salary compared to, you know, SNU professor. Then you need to have all this, you know, knowledge. Is it possible? Like, you know, so I have the two joke about this, you know, as a fashion designer, be fast, be cheap, then it's ugly. Be fast, be effective, it's of course more, then for a man, you know, handsome, smart, nice. This is only a joke, okay? Don't take it as too serious. So, which means that, you know, if TPAC is not that, I need to go back to my, where's my mouse? You know, I'm an old man right now, cannot see my mouse now. All right, anyhow, I want to go back to my original thing. It's here. Okay. All right, finally. So, you know, so this is why, you know, if we really want to improve teacher's TPAC, there must be, you know, all the different way you can read all the literatures. So the ICT policy in Taiwan, you know, in summary, you know, still very old. It hasn't changed for the past 20 years. It's still, you know, in the 2004. Then as a teacher, in technology, you only take one course, not required course. It's called media and instruction. So it's a quite also very, you know, and right now all the kids, they use smartphone, all that. So 10 years ago, my group has developed a MacDare model. We published in Teaching and Teacher Education and also in Australian Journal of Educational Technology. So, but it's like, you know, very complicated model. And also, you know, it takes about one semester, at least, you know, 36 hours in order to, you know, implement the MacMed model. So in 2019, I thought to myself, hey, is there any a better model which, you know, can be more efficiently, effectively, and also, you know, require less time? So if we can do that, maybe, you know, that's better. So I remember I first present this model in 2019 in Beijing Normal University. So I came up this term, it's called the core model. So it's actually why I use that, because the MacNair model, at that time we use Adobe Flash. Okay, we teach students how to use Adobe Flash to develop their own courses and they can teach it. But you know, technology, you know, advanced so fast, like, you know, every couple years, you have this, you know, like AVA, VR, metaverse, you know, blockchain, IoT, I don't know what's next, right? So, you know, when you keep changing that, so the MacNair model is actually based on the Adobe, but you know, when the big company say, we stop it, then you stop it, okay? So can we have a model is more independent of the technology? So, you know, doesn't matter what kind of technology you are using, then you just, you know, keep, you use the same model. So this is, you know, the reason behind we developed this decor model, okay? I'm speaking a little bit too fast because I want to cover the thing I want to share with you, okay? So this is, you know, how students right now are doing, okay? So in my lab, actually we develop a totally free online platform. If you know Kahoot, Socrates, you know, many different, you know, tools, we have the same tool. But this is the only tool I can show you will be free forever, okay? Everybody can use it, although we don't look good like, you know, Kahoot or the IRS, but this is good. So we use this platform to implement our decode model, okay? So if you are interested, you can just type the website, ccr.tw. Right now we have many users, we have, you know, all the different languages, okay? So I'm not give you, you know, detail this thing about the cloud classroom. So the cloud classroom, actually there are so many functions, and right before the pandemic 2019, we were selected as one of the example project by Horizon Report, which is an influential e-learning report, okay? So the disadvantage of the freeze model back there, it's time consuming and complicated. Can I make it more simple and easy to use? So I'm gonna present you the decode model. I call it the decode. We try to decode the teacher professional development. So if we can use this model to decode it, maybe make it, you know, more simple to use, okay? And so the decode means, first of all, the teacher demonstrate, okay, how you use this technology, be it a cloud classroom developed by my team, be it VR, AR, any technology you use, you demo how you really implement that in your own class. The demo can be, you know, 1 hour, 2 hours, depending upon how complicated is your, you know, teacher content. Then after you demo that, okay, here we use, of course, because my group developed cloud classroom CCR, so we use that example. So after your demonstration, maybe, you know, several hours, maybe 1 week, I don't know, depending upon. Then you ask the students, actually those are either in-service teacher or pre-service teacher. They try to co-learn how to use this, you know, new tools. Then they also co-design this, you know, the module, which are going to be implemented in their own class. Then they also, like, you know, co-design, co-tag, and also co-teach. So after the co-teach, then they're receiving feedback from their peers. Then they will give the, you know, hey, you know, you need to improve it, improve there. Then afterwards, they also, after that, they need to debriefing what they really have learned. Then they also can come back, you know, this is a loop. They co-tag, co-teach, and the co-design again, okay? Then, you know, if you have a new technology, you can also like use this technology to do the decode again. All right, so this is seems like, you know, quite simple. I think I coined the term decode, but I don't think, even though I use the term, I don't think I'm the first one, you know, to invent this. I think many people doing the same thing. Okay, I just, you know, make it, you know, a nice name like decode, okay? All right. So then I would like to present you several studies we have been doing for the past 3-4 years. And we also move the decode. You don't need to do it in person like this. You can do it online. So I'm gonna introduce you several studies I've been doing. So Sonia, I have how many minutes? 17. But that's okay, right? So I can, you know, I finish early. Everybody can, you know, have feedback, question, then I can, you know, our next speaker can, you know, we can catch time, right? Okay, so I'm gonna give you the example, okay? I first pilot this study in Thailand. So there's the first science senior high school, it's called Mahidol Senior High School, maybe you know that. So the Mahidol Senior High School, we actually, you know, I went there, you know, you see all the teachers. I tried to pilot this decode model the first time. So give you a little bit background since I have 70 minutes, so I can give you a little bit detail. So I was an instructor, do the demonstration. They got 30 in-service teachers. More than half of them, 16 to 18 years of teaching experience. Okay, so that's a background. You know, actually, one third of teachers earn a doctorate degree abroad. Their salary is actually much higher than a professor in Thailand. So this is how they cultivate the next generation of scientists, you know, engineer. So, you know, after I learned that, I went back to Taiwan and said, hey, maybe we should learn from Thailand. But the government say, no way, okay? We don't want to make, you know, exception for those things. So this is a snapshot of my demonstration using the cloud classroom, then the code tag, then, you know, this is how they are, you know, implement, then the code design. This is one of their course they are designing. So this is like 2-day workshop. Okay, so a different type of thing. So I want to, you know, go through it because I have several studies I want to tell you. Then they will give us like, you know, after they give you know, like a teaching, they're receiving feedback. Then I also did a very quick survey regarding that. So this is the teacher's feedback on how they, how will you use the cloud classroom in your own classroom? So they have some feedback, you know, regarding this technology. So they are also willing to use that in their own class. So which is good, okay? So then later on the pandemic come, I start to say, okay, why did this first study in Thailand instead of in Taiwan? I should use that in my own class. So then I use in my own class, okay? So this is the study we did in Taiwan. These are the background about the participants, my graduate students, undergraduate students. Then we do, of course, you know, pre-post tests, okay, all that. Okay, so very, you know, standard procedures. All right, so of course we have an instrument on the TPAC, right? As I mentioned, you know, 7 circles, right? So you have CK, PK, PCK, TK, blah, blah, blah. Okay, TPAC, okay? All right, so then we did, you know, so then student, after I did the demonstration and student co-teach. So, okay, a quick result on the first study we published, okay? So as you can see here from those pre-service teachers, this, you know, pre-course on the instrument, okay? You can see from this result, although we have like good effect size, you know, like, you know, 0.8, 0.97, you know, you can see, but all the major significant difference are from the technology itself, okay? So which means that, you know, because we use Cloud Classroom as our tool, so the teachers, preserving teacher, they are, their performance are improved in the technology, more on the technology part. As you can see from the content knowledge, PK, PCK, they are not significant, which makes sense to me. Which means that, you know, originally you want to improve their TPAC. But at the same time, of course, you know, you won't be able to improve all the, you know, 7 circles, okay? So as I mentioned, you know, it's not easy, right? Okay, right. So anyhow, so then students also got some feedback on the T-core model, okay? All right, so so I'm gonna skip this slide because, you know, this is a discussion. If you are interested in this paper, it's publishing, I think it's gonna index in Science Citation Index. It's already in Scopus, the, you know, this journal. All right, so later on the pandemic comes, okay? You know, when the pandemic changed everything, hey, you develop a very good model, then it can only be used in the face-to-face. So how about, you know, what if the next pandemic comes? My decode model will be, you know, gone. So I don't want that happen. So I tried to convince one of my colleagues in Vietnam. This university is actually in the south, Anyang University, very close to a very popular island, okay, tour. So I collaborated with them to do a study and implement the decode model in the university for the pre-service teacher. And fully online. It's fully online. So what we did is, you know, we use Zoom. Then I demo the cloud classroom, you know, with a class, with a micro unit using Zoom. Then the teachers, you know, start to learn that. Then they repeat the, you know, code design, code tech, code teach. Then, you know, they come back. Okay. So we put it, you know, fully online. So this is how, you know, we look, okay, on Zoom. Okay. All right. So the reason we want to emphasize the inquiry is we try to make inquiry as a very important, because it's very important for science STEM class. Okay, of course, then we need to include the inquiry instrument. Okay, inquiry teachers teaching inquiry ability appeared, you know, in this study. So this is also another Decor model. You already know that. So there are several questions, question one, two, three, four, regarding, you know, to what extent this, I call it IoT, okay? Just, you know, another fancy name, okay? All right. Anyhow, so this is a different question. So I'd like to go to the, so different stage you have, you want to address different kind of, you know, research question. So I think because this is a very detailed, we just finished the manuscript. 10? Okay. So we just finished this study, I think during the pandemic. So right now we have prepared the full manuscript ready to submit. So this is the detailed decor in the during like the online, like week one, week two, it's synchronous, okay? So then 3, 4, we actually use Google Classroom for students to submit their assignment or that. Then we come back to take a look, you know, they present, you know, what they have been, you know, doing with this. Then we come back again. So this is kind of like a cyclic model for the Decor model and fully online. So as you can see from this TPAC final results, same thing, sort of same thing here, okay? So you see like, you know, the technology related things has been, you know, significantly improved, but however, the content, PK, PCK, you know, a little bit improved, but you know, that's significant. So from this figure, you will see the Decor model, although serve its original purpose, you know, like, you know, improve the TPAC, but still, if you want to do more, maybe we should do more things, okay? So this is from the pre-survey till, you know, post-survey, although, you know, you can see the effect size are most significant in the technology-related thing, because this is a new cloud classroom. I think they kind of like use it, but you are also welcome to use it, because, and you can just use it. You don't need to get my permission, because, you know, it's a free platform for everyone in the world. Although there's a sad story behind this, I think Sonya know that, right? Because my former student, Yoda, Jian Yoda, he passed away, but before he passed away, my excellent student, he said he want to make a cloud classroom, you know, as available to everyone in the world. So, you know, me and his high school student, right now also my engineer, we try to, you know, fulfill his wishes. All right, so, we also have some lesson plan, because this is from Vietnam, so I have two students a master's degree right now, went back to Vietnam to teach. So, you know, we're doing the analysis on the lesson plan, you know, we review, then after that, they revise the lesson plan, okay? Since it's all in Vietnamese, I haven't done any work. Only my students, because, you know, they need to give them comments and then they review it. So this is kind of like, you know, they revise it. So as you can see from here, the inquiry score seems like, you know, teachers' inquiry score also increased a little bit, okay? So which is what we need, okay? And also their TPAC scoring for the lesson plans. So I'm gonna skip this because, you know, I'm afraid that, you know, I will be running out of time, okay? So this is, if you are interested, I can also share the manuscript to you. This actually summarizes what the Decor model, the fully online Decor model has been, you know, working or, you know, effective without those teachers. So different type of students with different background, they will have, you know, different type, you know, needs for the TPAC. So this is, you know, maybe the major finding from this, okay? Anyhow, I want to move to another study we just recently done, okay? So this is a happy fest at the end of the course, okay? Hopefully everybody is happy. So I want to, study we just have done in January, the end of January, okay? So this is also a fully online Decor model, but actually right now we are adding R at the end, instead of Decor, right now it becomes a Decoder. The reason is, you know, I give this Decor model to Vietnam's university during the pandemic. So one teacher raised a question, hey, Professor Zhang, so, you know, okay, I know you are doing this workshop for those teachers. How about will they really implement, leverage on their, learn TPACK, then implement in their own classroom? Or will this just stop, at the professional development, they got their certification, then that's it, okay? Are they going to implement in the real classroom? I say, yeah, maybe we should do that, okay? We need to to investigate. After all this, increase TPACK, what will be the effect on their role on real classroom? So after that workshop, just last year, I think, we had another word called R, okay? So the decoder right now, thanks to Vietnamese colleagues, so the participant, if they are willing to do that, they are going to implement in their own real classroom. So right now we have an R. So we just did that, with UPI University, Indonesia University of Education, okay? Then, okay, good. So this is how we did, okay? So at the end of January, just 2 months ago, we have online workshop, okay? Number one, because I don't know in Bahasa Indonesia. So I asked one of my doctor students, she's from Indonesia. Her name is Asni, Asni Daisy. So they, I give some introduction, of course. Then they are doing this teacher's demonstration in Bahasa Indonesia for the first workshop. Then we divide a student, actually those are in-service teacher, into group. So they still co-tag, co-design, co-teach the course and then give the briefing. Then afterwards, they actually implement in their own real classroom. So then we will have some more. So this is ongoing research we have been doing. So this is actually, I have right now two doctor students, they are from Indonesia, asking me, Daisy, you will see their photo at the end of my talk. Okay, so same decor. So I'm gonna skip this one because only maybe 3 minutes. Okay, here. So it's a STEM class because the all men are the, STEM teachers. Okay, so this is the preliminary results, because it just came out several weeks ago. So this is the CCR, of course. The CCR can be replaced to any technology use if you use it correctly. So it has a potential. So these are the preliminary results include, we also try to see the knowledge of STEM, knowledge use, all that in this research, okay? Because there are still analysis of the data, okay? Okay, so this is a preview result. Seems like, the teacher know how to use that. They also implement it. And we are also doing some qualitative study interview with those teachers. Okay, so I think I'm gonna skip here. Then, so ongoing project, not only in Indonesia, we also do it in Taiwan. This has been just submitted to teaching and teacher education, but this has more related to self-regulated learning for the service teacher, because I don't want my students to replicate the same thing, although it's in different country. I want them to find a unique feature. Like for this one, another doctor student from Taiwan, he's trying to investigate self-regulated learning, through this decor model. Okay, skip this. I think I'm running out of time. Then finally, I want to go back 1 minute. Okay. Wow. Sonia, you are giving me too much, too many pressure. Finally, okay. Technology then so fast. So right now, cloud classroom. Although we survived 10 years, but all the technology you see, it's gonna be, out of date in some time, okay? So right now with the ChatGPT, right? So we want to, if we really want, our, as teachers can really, have a, good professional. So in Li Shuman's final work, he say, those who really understand teach successfully, okay? So the teacher, they really understand the interaction between technology, content, pedagogy. They really understand, then they can really implement, then they can teach successfully. In that way, teaching profession will become a very good thing, for all the teachers, okay? All right, so we have, if you, any colleagues also, interested in working with us, it's gonna be good, okay? Finally, all the my current students, they are very happy. I don't know, maybe not, okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Zhang, for your fun and impressive presentation on how we could help pre-service teachers develop their technological and pedagogical and content knowledge through the D-Code model. So I wonder if anyone has a question to ask Dr. Zhang. And you could also use this app to ask your questions either in Korean or in English through your phone. Yeah, he's bringing a microphone to you.
During last years, you developed many lines of the He Who Teach versions. Last time, I only see 3 versions. I can see a lot of interesting things. I have a question, one or two questions. I think your model is very comprehensive, and I think it looks quite working very well. But I'm thinking, do you have enough time to do perform that kind of model in the class, like a co-teaching, co-tech, co-design? These kind of things are all quite time-consuming, actually, right? But we do have a limited time in the class. So is there any conflict or constraint?
Yeah, you're right. Thank you so much for the good question. So actually, I was going to show a slide. You know, right now, in addition to Indonesia, right now, the D-Code model is currently, we are going to implement in India. It's a rural, you know, university, and also another one in Vietnam. So what we are doing right now is, of course, you are right, because when it comes after the teacher demo some like a unit, example unit, they know, wow, it looks like this, like that. Then when you ask them to start to co-tech, co-design, co-teach, it really takes time. So what we have been doing is like, you know, we actually ask students to work together, like, you know, 2 or 3, they work together. But however, during class, maybe just 1 or 2 class period, but afterwards, of course, they need to use their own time as a homework, right? So they need to go back, you know, finding time to discuss among themselves, then design the course, and then coming back to present. So what we are doing with in India, actually in mid-April, we will give the first workshop 3 hours, then that's okay? And the part of a core CEO is also in the workshop. So they will divide into group. But however, the second workshop will be on Saturday. For example, we'll give the first workshop on Monday. Then students need to, not only in the workshop, but they are going to co-design, co-tech, all that in a week. Then on Saturday, they are going to present what they have done. So for the India research we are going to do in April is they are going to work together after the class. So which means that, of course, it's going to be consume their own time. But we found out that, like, you know, the D-Code model should be adapted to different country situation. For example, in Taiwan, when we have done that, we actually the teacher, because the teacher registered for the teacher's workshop. So the workshop sometimes is a series of different workshops. So if they want to attend the second one, they need to finish something in order to come to the second one. So this is how we are doing right now with the in-service teacher. But you are absolutely right. This is a constraint, because when you come to the whole stage, it's actually a very time consuming. The reason we don't do too much time, we don't want to spend too much time on the demonstrations, like, you know, because once you have one demonstration from the instructor, you know, actually different instructor, their demonstration will be different, you know, because it can be thousands. But however, when students come to present and the debriefing what they know, then you will see all the different groups, they have their own, you know, way using the technology to teach. Then they're receiving feedback from, you know, their peers. So we actually move the demonstration, although it's a teacher, but finally it's actually, you know, the you know, peer groups, they are going to do that. Yeah. Thank you so much. So right now the D-Code model only several years, but we believe it's very simple and easy to use. Okay. But I want to say again, you know, you this is not, you know, I'm not in my invention. You know, I believe many teacher, professor, they have their own kind of, you know, this type of thing. Okay. So I just, you know, coined the term before. Okay.
Yeah, and there's another question on the screen. So in your decode model, in the co, the CO stage, what do you mean by the co-design? Like, what does it look like? Like, what kinds of activities does that include is the question.
Okay. So good question. So the co-design is actually, you know, usually we will, you know, depending upon different, you know, how many participants. So usually 3 to 4 teachers, in-service, pre-service, they will form a group. So they are going to, because they now they know the technology, they know the, you know, the how to use the technology in the micro unit. So they know the demonstration. So they are going to, then they start to design together. So I have shown some slides in Thailand, you know, in Taiwan study, several of them. So they co-design their own course together, not by individually, because we think it's kind of like collaborative learning. So if they can do it together, actually, you know, they can receive input from each other. For example, for the India research, we are going to do it. They are going to, like, you know, those teacher institute, they have a teacher background from mathematics, STEM, all these 40 area. So we actually force, you know, a science teacher need to work with a mathematics teacher, technology teacher, and engineering teacher. So we want them, you know, you got to from different background in order to design a more integrated interdisciplinary. So when they designed it, they will say, okay, what kind of a, you know, question are really good for, you know, using Cloud Classroom to teach their lessons. So you, went through the slide very quickly, right? Very quickly. So it's actually, you know, they have biotech, waste, you know, management, you know, all the different things. But if you have teachers, participants from different backgrounds, you will see a very integrated, you know, content for that. So then they co-design that. After that, then they need to have one teacher to implement their, you know, the R part, implement their real classroom. So this is what we are right now conducting research in Indonesia.
Okay, and there's another question asking, does students in the decode model mean pre-service teachers?
Yes. So sometimes I use students because they are my students, right? So actually they are pre-service teacher. Yes, exactly. So right now also in-service teacher for the Vietnam, India, and also Taiwan. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So thank you for your presentation, and let's give him a big hand.